Hello everyone. In this video, I'll explain how to create employment documents from the SharePoint list with the help of Plumsail Documents and Power Automate. In case you're not familiar with Plumsail, Plumsail Documents feature an intuitive interface for creating documents from templates. In here, we have created a sample employee list on the SharePoint site with all the employees. When you hire a new remote employee, add a new item to this list, and it will contain information about the new employee such as full name, job title, employment date, probationary period, salary, address, phone, and email. When we click to add a new item to the list, we can see the form which was created and customized with Plumsail Form Designer app for SharePoint, which can be downloaded and installed on your computer. It offers some advanced form design features. Now, go back to Plumsail account and select Documents to create a document generation process. Processes are an easy way to automate the creation of documents from templates. And first, we have to create a new process. Two options are offered. One is Start from Template and Start from Blank. Start from Template offers many ready-to-go templates, and you can find appropriate template and try to edit it to fit your needs. Some examples are reports, invoices, accounting and tax, contracts, sales, and employment. And after you select one of your templates, you can go ahead and edit it to fit your needs or just to proceed. In our case, we will start from blank, give a name to process, and select docx as a template type. Next step is to configure template. There are two internal steps that we will guide you through configuration. It's editor and settings. The editor mode allows you to build the template from scratch or upload a pre-made one. It is possible to upload your own documents and transfer them into reusable templates by adding special placeholders, which will be populated dynamically. All you have to do is to replace all text which you usually copy and paste with special tokens in double curly brackets. Now we will choose an option to upload a new template which we already created and place special placeholders into appropriate spots. In this template, we can see placed tokens in double curly brackets. They are special placeholders that will be replaced with real data dynamically. If you're not happy with the template, we can also edit it online using Google Documents. In this case, I'm happy how everything looks, and I'll click Save and Next. In settings, we can choose the template mode to be testing or production mode and give our output file name and also use tokens, which I mentioned earlier, just to populate file name dynamically. I will add an employee name token. We can choose different output files like PDF, docx, and also there are some other advanced options which you can explore. Next step is to add delivery. In here, we can see many options. For this demonstration, we will deliver results to SharePoint library and email. So let's start with the SharePoint library first. Connect to your site, select the desired library and folder, and the outcome documents will be saved there. In here, we will type our folder name, click Save and Next. I will use tokens to dynamically create another folder with employee name. Now I will add another delivery via email. I will use Zoho Mail for this purpose. First, I have to connect to my email account and then set up the email template I would like to be sent out. And again, I can use tokens to automatically populate receiver's email address from the document and enter the subject and email body to our liking. And in the advanced settings, we can see display name and reply to address where tokens could be used as well. And we have finished the Plumsail process setup. Next step is to create flow with Power Automate. We will create an InstaCloud flow that will drive data from the SharePoint list. Now we can enter the flow name, and in this instance, we will select to trigger the flow with a SharePoint connector trigger for a selected item. This allows us to start the flow for any item in our SharePoint list. Copy our site address from the SharePoint and select the list name. A new step in our flow will be to get information about selected employee. This action from the SharePoint connector, it retrieves the information about the selected employee. The outputs are dynamic and are presented all in the columns like full name, position, salary, whatever you choose to be presented. Let's go to our next and the final step, and let's add an action that will trigger the created process. Start documents generation process with JSON is an action from the Plumsail Documents connector. If this is your first time using the Plumsail Documents connector, Power Automate will request the connection name and API key. So we can go back to our Plumsail account and add a new API key, give it a name, and copy the key and paste it. Once we are connected, we will need to select the process we created in the process name field and specify JSON data in the template data field and save it. I will fast forward this part and show the final outcome. Click save and our flow creation process is finished. After completing the flow creation process, we can click to my flows to see if our flow was saved. And here we go. Create employment contract flow is saved. Now we will switch to SharePoint to trigger the flow by selecting an employee and clicking on automate and selecting our flow. Click on continue and run flow. If you remember at the beginning of this video, we choose to deliver documents to our SharePoint library and via email. We can check if delivery was successful by clicking on documents, then employees folder. We also selected that we want to create a separate folder for each employee dynamically. And our contract with automatically populated data is ready in SharePoint library in a Word document. And our second delivery method was via email. So let's check that one out. As we can see, it was also attached and sent via email to the specified email address, which was taken from the SharePoint list. You can use this approach to create any document based on SharePoint list data. It is very useful and handy to automate all of your repetitive everyday tasks. I hope you find this video useful, and please let us know in the comment section below how do you automate your employment contract creation process and which software do you use. If you'd like to try Plumsail, click on the link below and you will get access to 30-day free trial. And thank you for watching.